Hello, dear students. Let us continue with our discussion on that problem. So, in the last session, we stopped with the calculation of T5. It was calculated as 242.89 Kelvin. Now the same application, now let us apply the same concept to the expander cylinder. Isentropic efficiency of the expander cylinder, it can be calculated like this: T4 minus T5 dash by T4 minus T5. How that came? Actually, we can look at the value of the isentropic efficiency of the expander given. It is 0.8, which means less than 1. So when we write this ratio, the numerator should be less than the denominator. Okay, so when we look back at our TS diagram, let us take the TS diagram. So we can observe here 4 to 5 was the ideal or isentropic expansion process. 4 to 5 dash 4 to 5 dash is the actual expansion process or expander process. So the temperature drop happening during the actual process is T4 minus T5 dash, which will be less than the temperature drop from 4 to 5. So if you can observe here, you can clearly see T4 minus T5 will be higher than T4 minus T5 dash. So that is why we are writing. We are writing the isentropic efficiency of the expander as T4 minus T5 dash by T4 minus T5. So the only unknown term here is T5 dash. So by cross multiplying here with the 0.8, we can calculate the value of T5 dash as 256.528 Kelvin. Now the remaining part of the question is, in order to we need to find the volume flow rate of the air, the working fluid, which is nothing but air, at the inlet of the compressor. Okay, so at the inlet of the compressor means it is the 0.2. So the inlet of the compressor, let us take our the inlet of our compressor, we can take consider our TS diagram. This was our TS diagram. The inlet of our compressor is 0.2. Okay, so we can come back. So at the inlet of the compressor, we need to find out the volume flow rate, which means V2. And in order to find out V2, we can use our simple ideal gas relation P2 V2 is equal to MRT2, where P2 is the pressure. P volume and mass flow rate, characteristic gas constant R, and temperature at 2. So how to find out this how to calculate this volume flow rate at 2? So in order to find the volume flow rate at 2, P2 is known, characteristic gas constant we can calculate, T2 is also known, but nothing is mentioned about the mass flow rate of the working fluid or air. So any idea how we can proceed with this mass flow rate of air? So mass flow rate of air, one more data is given in the question. That is, this refrigerator is working in 100 TR, or the capacity of 100 TR. So what is meant by this 100 TR? Means it is the refrigeration effect. So which is our refrigeration step in our aircraft refrigeration cycle? So let us come back to our TS diagram. So always we will be referring back to our TS diagram. That is why I told you initially itself we should try to draw the TS diagram. Then only we can easily understand or proceed with the solving. So the air which is coming out from the cooling turbine and at the 0.5 dash, it is moving towards the cabin which is at 6. Okay, it is at the cabin which is at the 0.6. The passengers, the payload, the electronic equipments will be kept. So the air coming out from 5 dash, while it is passing through the cabin 6, it is creating or it is absorbing the heat from the cabin, or the refrigeration effect is happening, or the refrigeration step is happening from 5-6. So 5-6 is our 5-6 is our refrigeration step. 5-6 is our refrigeration step. So 5-6 is our refrigeration step. So by applying our simple MCP delta TY, the heat absorbed during this refrigeration process is nothing but MCP delta TY. CP stands for constant pressure. So no pressure changing device is happening, or there is no pressure changing process happening after the air has left the cooling turbine. Okay, so after the air has left the cooling turbine at 5-, on its travel towards the cabin, the cooling atmospheric air or the working fluid air is not at all getting pressurized or non-pressurized, or it is not undergoing any expansion process or any compression process. So we can it can be considered as a constant pressure process. So the heat refrigeration effect is nothing but the heat absorbed from the cabin, and that is given as the 100 TR. So 100 times 3.5 will give us in kilojoules per second. This kilojoule per second will be equal to MCP delta T. So the only unknown term here is the mass flow rate, that is M, and CP value is given in the question. T6 is also given in the question, that is 25 degrees Celsius. So 25 plus 273 over here. Then T5- we have already found out, it is 256.52 Kelvin. So cross multiplying, we can find the mass flow rate as 8.39 kilojoules kilogram per second. So here this mass flow rate is nothing but the mass flow rate of the working fluid or air passing through the compressor cylinder at the inlet of the compressor cylinder. So by applying by substituting this mass flow rate at this V2 is equal to m dot into RT2. This m dot we have just now found out as 8.39 kilogram per second. Substitute it here. So the only unknown term in this relation one, this PVT relationship, is V2. Okay, the only unknown term is V2. So we can easily find out the value of V2, or the volume flow rate of the air at the compressor inlet will be equal to 12.91 meter cube per second. Okay, similarly, the volume flow rate of the working fluid, that is air, at the expander outlet. Okay, so we already have seen, that is the actual expander outlet is coming at 5-. So we need to find out the V5-. So again, use the PVT relationship. V5-, is equal to MRT5-. So here also the mass flow rate remains the same. We have already found out as 8.39 kilogram per second. Okay, so substitute that value. The only unknown term here is V5-. Cross multiplying, we can easily find out the value of the volume flow rate at expander outlet as 5.82 meter cube per second. So this is the end of our problem now. So all of you, please practice doing this. Okay, thank you.